Hey everybody, Afro Gamer Richard here, and I'd just like to start off with this video by saying Merry Christmas to everyone, and thank you all for supporting my channel over the year. You've all been great, and I wouldn't be here without you all, so thank you very much. Okay, so I'm back on Destiny, and I just really want to... I've been thinking about a name for my Destiny series, and I come up with... I don't know if you guys will like this name or not, but I thought I'd give it... my series of videos for Destiny a name, and I'm going to call it The Daily Grind. Now, this doesn't mean I'm going to be doing daily videos, but obviously all you guys that play Destiny will understand about the daily grind within the game. So let us know what you think about the name of it in the comments section below, and that'd be fantastic. Okay, so basically this video, it's a quick video really. I'm not too sure what's going to happen in it as of yet, but it's all about this weapon here that I've got equipped. Now, this weapon is... a drop from Hive, and I've got a couple of these on Earth when killing the Blades of Crota and things like that and stuff. So basically it's here, Husk of the Pit. Now it looks rubbish, 138 attack, white, yeah, it's no, it don't look anything fancy at all, but as you can see it's a DLC item, and I really just want to go over this. So I've been told that this weapon is upgradable, so I went in and had a look at it, and you got this here. So cannibalism, husk exudes sense of sinister satisfaction when used to expire its former allies. So basically what that means is, to upgrade this weapon you need to go and kill Hive. You need to kill quite a lot. It took me a couple of hours of grinding it out to obviously max it out, and then once you've done that you also need to be level 3 with Eris Morn, I believe her name is, which is obviously the go-to gal for the DLC on the tower. And once you've leveled up to rank 3 with her, which I'd done earlier on today, you can get these here, embalming orbs. Now, basically what these are for, it says here, used to upgrade weapons of Hive origin. Now, I thought there's going to be weapons that she gives to you or anything like that, but it's actually what I believe, well, what I know now, is use them to upgrade here, so... I'm not too sure what's going to happen when I use this. I've been looking forward to using it because I've been told something exciting does happen from a mate, but it's all speculation because I've not actually seen one of these yet. There might be people who have got them upgraded already, so I thought I'd share my experience with you guys. Let's see what happens. So I've got an embalming orb, and well, let's see what happens. I'm going to click it to upgrade it. There we go. Oh, right, so it is true. There we go. So it upgrades it to a legendary auto rifle. Now, it's got 42 in the magazine, low impact but extremely high rate of fire. Maximum of 324 damage. That's not bad. Yeah, it's not bad at all. Okay, so what does it do? Melee kills increase the reload speed of this weapon for a short time, and aiming with this weapon increases its effective range. So obviously, yeah, looking down the scope will make it more accurate. Alright, fair enough. So, quarter combat ballistics greatly reduces recoil, significant penalty to range, and aggressive ballistics, more predictable recoil, enhanced impact, shorter range, and more recoil. So slightly more impact there. I'll probably go for that once I've upgraded it. Cascade. Melee kills increase the reload speed of this weapon for a short time. Upgrade damage. Single point sling. Switch weapons faster. Move quickly whilst aiming. Flared magwell. Reload weapons even faster. Also, reload this weapon even faster. Sorry, I do apologise. And fitted stock. Increase weapon stability. Okay, what else is there? Range finder. So that's the aiming with this weapon increases its effective range. And the rest of these will just be the upgrade damage. But going hunger. What power drives this appetite? It grows after each meal. Crux of Crota. Ooh. Now that seems interesting. I wonder what that does then. What power drives this appetite that grows after each meal? I'm really intrigued to find out what it is now. Obviously... that looks like you have to kill Crota, and that'll be a drop from him. So I'm going to have to get in about the raid now and give that a bash, just to see what exactly that is. So as you can see here, the upgrade materials needed for this is your Ascendant Energy, the Crux of Crota, and relic iron. So yeah, it does say here, Crux of Crota, obtained only by defeating the son of Oryx and the heir to Osmium, of to the Osmium throne, and the raid's most difficult mode. Okay, so you've got to do it on hard mode. Okay, I've not even done it on normal mode yet, so that's going to be an experience. But never to fear, I am level 31 already. Maybe with a couple bits of raid gear, I'll get up to level 32 and battering about that with a few mates. And once I have, I shall get this weapon fully upgraded and grab hold of one of those Cruxes, and I shall find out what the Begoaning Hunger does. Sounds extremely interesting, and we shall find out. So yeah, so basically, the Husk of the Pit, if you guys come across one of these, hang on to it, because I actually deconstructed about three of those, I think, before finding out what they're actually done. But luckily I'd stuck one in the bank just because of the skin and it actually looks quite cool. So hang on to them, guys. And then get up to level 3 with Eris Morn in the tower by doing her dailies. And then buy one of the Embalming Orbs and equip it or upgrade the Husk of the Pit, and you will get one of these weapons. Now it looks pretty cool. I really love the skin on that, so I'm going to go out now and give it a bash, see what it's all about. Hopefully it fires as quick as the Husk of the Pit, because, I mean, that was just ridiculous. It fired so fast. It never done much damage. It was doing like 50 damage for a headshot or something like that. And, yeah, it was taking forever to down enemies with it. So you're best to, if you want to quickly boost for it, go and do the Moonstrike on level 12 or something like that, just to batter through the enemies and upgrade it quickly. You could possibly also use, I'm not sure if these work, I don't see why they wouldn't, but auto rifle telemetry. Obviously that, I think that doubles the speed of development for upgrading your weapons. Get a few of those from Xur if you can. They cost one strange coin each. So jump in there and yeah, just hopefully you'll enjoy the weapon as much as I enjoyed the original version of it. So anyways, like I said, I'm going to go out and give this a go now, see if it's any good. If it is, I'll let you know what it's like as I'm upgrading it. And as soon as I've got one of the Cruxes, I shall get it fully upgraded, and I'll make another video just let you know what that final upgrade does, because it sounds extremely interesting, and it's shrouded in mystery, which is really, really wanting me to go and upgrade it now. So yeah, anyway, I'm rambling on here, so hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, please remember to hit that like button, leave a comment below, and obviously let us know what you think of the daily grind title for this series as well. And I shall see you all soon. Thank you all for watching. Take care. Bye. Submitted requisition data. Requesting approval.